Welcome you all in the video lecture series of Engineering Mathematics. In this section, we are going to discuss about the Fourier series. And in the topic Fourier series, we are going to discuss about half range Fourier series. So earlier you have studied about the full range Fourier series of the periodic function with period 2 pi, 2L, and the Fourier series of even and odd functions. So in this section, we are going to deal with the half range Fourier series. A series which contains only sine terms or cosine terms is called a half range Fourier sine or cosine series respectively. So you have seen in the Fourier series, it has two different expansion or series. We have cos and sine. So only one either sine or cos we can have in the half range series. So we expand the function fx in the range of 0 to pi in the Fourier series of period 2 pi. Similarly, you have studied about the L form. So here the range will be 0L and the Fourier series of the period 2L we consider. So the first we see here the half range cosine series. To find the expansion of the function fx in the range 0L, which consists of only cosine terms, it means in this Fourier series the terms exist only the cosine cos terms only. How we do this? Suppose we have given the function fx so that we reflect in the vertical axis, so that fx is equal to minus x will be there. Thus, the original function together with its extension is even in the interval of minus L to plus L. So by making this function, by making the given function fx in the form of even function, we extend the function in the form of cosine series. So the Fourier series of fx will contain only cosine terms, and it is given as fx is equals to a0 by 2 plus summation an cos n pi x upon L. So here you can see it is a Fourier series of the even function, where a0 is 2 by L integration fx dx and an integration fx cos n pi x upon L dx. Similarly, we extend the function fx by reflecting it in the origin, so that f of minus x is minus of fx. So by having this term, the extension function will be odd and its Fourier expansion will contain only the sine term. As we know, the Fourier expansion of the odd function contain only sine terms. The same way, the Fourier series of fx will be given as fx is equal to summation bn sin n by x upon L. So function, if it is in the first quadrant, then it will reflect in the third quadrant for the odd function. So where bn is 2 upon L, 0 to L fx sin n by x upon L dx. Let's take one example of the half range sine and cosine series. In the first example, we have to find the Fourier series of the function, where function fx is given as fx is equal to x and it lie between 0 to L. So as you can see in the figure, the function fx is equal to x is given and that its reflection extended in the second quadrant from 0 to minus L. So the graph of function fx in the interval 0 L is shown, and OA is reflect fx is equal to x. Now we extend this fx. As we know, the interval minus L to L is the in the second quadrant. such that the extended function fx represent an even function in the interval minus L to plus L. We know the even function is symmetry about the y-axis, so that we have done here, so that the extended function fx lie between minus L to plus L and it is even function. Thus, the fx over the full period 2L will contain only the cosine terms, and it is given as fx is equal to a0 by 2 plus summation an cos n pi x upon L. Now here we have to find a0. A0 is given as 2 upon L 0 to L fx dx, and fx is x between 0 to L. So the simple integration you have, it is x square by 2, by putting the limit it is finally L. The value of a0 you get L here. Now we go for the an. By formula it is 2 upon L integration fx cos n pi x upon L dx. So by putting the fx value of fx, it is x cos n pi x upon L. So here we use integration by part. So by using integration by part, we get here x as a first function and cos n pi x upon L is the second function. So it is 2 by L x L upon n pi sin n pi x upon L minus differentiation of x, that is 1, integration of cos n pi x upon L, and again integration of, so in short it is integration of sin n pi x upon L. So total is minus L squared upon n square pi square cos n pi x upon L. So by applying the limit here, so as you know, by putting the limit L, the sine will, sine n pi x upon L will be the first term, sine n pi, it is going to be 0. And for cos, it is L square upon n square pi square cos n pi. By putting x is equal to 0, it is going to be L square upon n square pi square. So finally, by putting the value of these values in a simple way, it is 2 upon L. So it is 2L upon n square pi square cos n pi minus 1. As you know, the cos n pi is what? It is minus 1 to the power n, where n is any positive integer. So in that case, an is what? Minus 4L upon n square pi square when n is odd, and it is 0 when n is even. So thus we get the value of a0 and an. We have now the value of an, that is minus 4L upon n square pi square when n is odd and 0 when n is even, and a0 is L. So by putting these two values, we get the required Fourier cosine series of fx over the half range 0 to L. So this is our required Fourier cosine series. As you know, for n is odd number, we have the value of an. So fx is going to be L by 2 minus 4L upon pi square cos pi x upon L plus 1 by 3 square cos 3 pi x upon L. By taking the odd terms only, this is our required Fourier series. So in next, now we see the second example. Here we have to represent the function fx as a Fourier sine series. But the thing is, we have taken the same function fx is equal to x, which lie between 0 to L. And here we require to find the half range sine series. So the graph of the function fx in the interval 0 to L is shown in the figure here. Now, as we see, to get the sine series, we extend the function in the third quadrant if it is in the first quadrant. So by taking this, it is going to be odd function. So by representing this odd function, our limit extended to minus L to plus L. And then we go for the Fourier series expansion of this given fx is equal to x. So by selecting the extended function fx over the full period 2L will contain only the sine terms, and that is given by fx is equal to summation bn sine n pi x upon L. Now we require to get here bn only. To get the bn, we have the formula bn is what? 2 upon L 0 to L fx sine n pi x upon L dx. So by putting the value of fx is equal to x, and again same way we apply the integration by part, that is 2 upon L x minus L upon n pi cos n pi x upon L and so on, which is shown in the screen here. So by putting the value of limit, the value of x, that is 0 and L, again sine n pi is going to be 0 and cos n pi is going to be minus 1 to the power n. So finally we get here 2L upon n pi minus 1 to the power n. The required half range Fourier sine series, half range Fourier series or Fourier sine series we say here, it is fx is 2L upon n pi sine pi x upon L minus 1 by 2 sine 2 pi x upon L and so on. So this is our required Fourier sine series for the same function fx is equal to x. So in this way we understand how to get the Fourier sine series and Fourier cosine series for the same function fx is equal to x. So thank you for watching this video. I hope so it make clear about the use of half range Fourier series on the function fx. It is also known as sine series or cosine series. Thank you for watching this video. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.